Hey guys, Jay on Real Guys Reviews. I want to thank a couple of you guys for the comments and ideas that you brought forth on Speedloading this little Pitbull 40. As you know, we talked a little bit about one method of doing that, and that's with a magazine that carries 40 calibers, and we're going to show that real quickly again and compare that to the methods that were discussed in our comments. And those methods include the Bianchi and Tuff Speedstrips. And we're going to utilize the Tuff Quickstrip today and compare that with loading the 38 as well as the 40 and comparing that with the magazine loading of the 40. It looks like both of these methods are going to work. Neither are real quick, not quite as quick as they are as they were designed with the 38, but certainly it'll get the job done. Okay, let's take a look at the 38. Now the speed strip of Bianchi and Tuff as well as the HKS speed loader, they were designed with a 38-357 in mind. And the reason it works so well with these is, again, as we discussed, there's no obstruction in the chambers. The 38-357, because of the rimmed cartridges, you can eject those, they grab hold of that rim, push them right out. You don't have to have the little ejector pins that this 40 has in it to grab hold of a rimless cartridge to get it out. So let's just take a look and see what we've got here. This is the Tuff Quickstrip, and the design is just to sit right in there, peels right out, very simple. That's designed with the 357 38 cal in mind, because after you peel this off, it just falls straight in. Okay, so now let's take a look, get these out first of all, get her set down, and let's take a look and see how this works with the 40 cal Pitbull. Okay, this is the Tuff speed loading strip, or quick strip as I call it. And again, you can use your index finger, use your thumb. Most of you that have commented on this, obviously you've been using these strips, so, or you wouldn't have commented. So let's take a look at it. As you notice, the 38, that just fell into place. That doesn't happen here because of the little, as you can tell, it's just not the same. And that's because we're having to deal with these little ejector pins. They're spring-loaded, they push down, but in dealing with those, it makes it harder to speed load in any manner. But let's take a look at the speed strip. We push it in, peel it. Now, you've got to then push these things in, and the reason is that you're dealing with a little obstruction in the chamber, and they don't let them just fall right in like they did with the 38. So it's a little bit different, but you know what? It works. Works quite well. So without doubt, this is another method of speed loading. I guess maybe, as we talked about before, it's not very speedy, but it does get the job done. So that's one method of doing it. And appreciate those comments. So that, guys, is a second method of getting this gun speed loaded. Now we're going to take a quick look also at the magazine that we looked at last time. Okay, now let's compare that to speed loading with a 40 caliber Glock magazine. You can use any 40 caliber magazine, but we're going to use a Glock because that's what I've got loaded right now. Another thing that we talked about in the last video that works quite nicely is if you're carrying a Glock 23, for instance, as your primary, carrying this as a backup, one set of magazines works in for both guns. So that is one advantage this may have. Maybe it doesn't for you, but it does for me. So let's see how easy this is to speed load also. So in doing this, we're going to use our thumb, and as we get the cartridge there, we push it straight in. This one, when you do that, the next cartridge actually pops right out for you. So this is very easy to do, and we've got her speed loaded. Okay, y'all, just a quick little video on two methods now of speed loading the little Pitbull 40 cal from Charter Arms. I like it. See y'all around at Real Guys Reviews. Thanks.